right, but this RG3, I want this card. It's gonna be hard to get him. Not even all of them are a million. There's only one that's a mil, and that's only because. Yeah, exactly. Alright, well then, golden tickets are on my list. The things to pick up, so I gotta. I'm about to go look at all the cards that are coming. Ricky Jackson's 260. See, Clowney just got sold for 311. I want that card. Really good. No, I'm not. I don't have the coins right now. But 85K, because I just bought my team back yesterday, so I'm just trying to build up my coins. Oh yes. I mean, that's perfect. Which is good, but that's gonna make like the lower. I don't know. Okay, so. Oh, I promise you, if he's any good, he's gonna be on my team, because that AP is gonna be like. Exactly. I don't know, I'll take a minus 4 speed for 8 AP. Oh!
The second one was the payoff. That was the big one that landed. two, end zone.
Now Janikowski following the score. He'll move this one away. That'll be taken about a yard deep. And they'll get it to the 5 yard line. So the same result that he opted for the touchback. Of a play fake. Here's Morgan. He'll buy some time. Right. Oh, he's going to take it. He's got a man. Complete. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. A very nice pickup of 33 yards. One of the things that led this organization to commit.
Oh, that's a good throw on the run release.
His ability to keep his eyes downfield and make plays out of the pocket. Able to see the receiver while on the move and complete a really accurate throw.
Here's a quick throw caught by Smith. And they went the wrong way there. Losing yardage back at the 43-yard line. He was unable to shake free there. They'll cover him for a loss of a yard. On second and 11 now. Morgan will get this into the hands of Moser. And he'll get it down to the play to the 37. Complete. 6 yards on the pickup. And that'll bring up a third down.
Oh, I came to my feet on that.
So 11-22.
Give some credit to the defense, finding a way to get to him and forcing a third down.
From the gun on third down, Morgan. And they will touch him down, but not before he gets the first.
That's good.
7 yards there, good enough to move the sticks.
First and 10 at the 30-yard line.
Play action with Morgan. Rolling to his right. On the run, he'll let this go deep right side. And he's going to look that one in one-handed. What a catch for the touchdown. He put quite a bit of air underneath that touchdown pass. Of course, we knew that he had the strong arm.
That part was easy. You could see that throughout his college career. He is. When the pressure's on, can you throw a touch? He just did right there. And boy, it was pretty.
Each team's had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. Takes this about 5 yards deep. And in hindsight, probably should have taken a knee as he only gets this out to the 16-yard line.
And 10 at their own 16-yard line.
The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. And they're hoping to redo their efforts.
I can't even get into a week of a game. I'll be back.
He's taken down. Back at his own 7. And a free safety blitz. That can be a gamble, but it proves fruitful there.
Yeah, you're exactly right about the gamble, because oftentimes the free safety is the last line of defense against a long pass. And when he comes at the quarterback, he better get home and make the play. Otherwise, a big play could result for the offense.
Throwing on second and long. Vic. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
And that's one of those plays where it's hard to keep two eyes on the football when you know the contact's coming, let alone getting two hands around it, hugging it to your body, and absorbing the hit. Even for those big tight ends, who you would think could absorb that contact.
Drops incomplete as he got popped as he was throwing it.
And this is what you want to see from a defense. Give up an opening drive touchdown, that's fine. But how about them going back out there, recommitting themselves to the task at hand, and forcing a three and out and giving the ball back to their offense.
Here's Cameron Johnston now, as his first punt will come from inside his own end zone. It's a 46-yard punt with a loss on the return. And the Saints will take over with a first down and 10.
Titans offense. And they'll be looking to build off of a nice drive last time, a drive that really relied on the quarterback.
Making good decisions, distributing the ball well, distributing it accurately, keeping it away from danger, a really nicely run drive.
But now the defense, what adjustments do they need to make in the passing game?
Pass rush, pass rush, pass rush. Whether it's the guys up front, or maybe you bring additional guys, but you've got to disrupt the timing of them throwing the football.
We'll see if they can disrupt it here. Escaping the pressure lane. It's third and long, because remember, they also lose a down on the grounding call. Morgan off of play action. Looking downfield for Dez. This is taken in. It's complete. And he is going to have a Saints first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
There's the arm strength that we saw in college and during the scouting process. And really, it's not just the arm strength there, but the placement as well. To me, that was an excellent combination of arm talent and accuracy.
Morgan sets up to throw on first down. Flush to his right. On the run, he'll let this go deep right side. And that will fall incomplete. Oh, they took a shot there on what will turn out to be the final play of this first quarter. So second down and 10. Once again, they'll go from the 40. They'll let the QB keep it here off the option. 5 yards. Now it's third and 5. Well, that's what he can do, you know, when he keeps the football. It's not a huge gain, but it shows how hard it can be to stop him.
Yeah, and I thought the defense had that one pretty well contained, and in fact, they probably came up and felt pretty good about what they did. Then they looked up and realized he still got good yardage out of it. He's a tough guy to stop.
Morgan now from the gun on third down. He'll rifle this one deep right side. He dropped it. Couldn't hang on in the end zone. So no 6 points, incomplete.
Nice play there to force the incompletion. And to me, one thing's for sure. When you're the underdogs and you're playing on the road, you absolutely have to get takeaways. You've got to get the ball from them.
Yeah, win that turnover battle, going to be key. They didn't get one there, but you get the feeling they keep making plays like that, they might just get a few.
Yeah, once you get one, defensive teams think they can win bunches.
This is incomplete. The Saints' decision to go for it backfires. And as a result, possession switches hands. The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. And they're coming off a 3-and-out, my friend.
They need to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't climbed before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense moving.
Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what you called before, realize it hasn't worked
so well. Go to something else.
And maybe try and find one of those special plays from one of your better players, and maybe try and hit something big and get things going in the excitement area.
The throw on second down from Vic, incomplete. Looking for his all-pro tight end, Rob Gronkowski, and it's third down.
To this point, I've been impressed with the work defensively. They have not allowed a lot of receivers to run free. And there's another example, another incompletion.
That throw by Vic, incomplete.
How about some applause for the defense there? They forced him to throw that one into coverage, and just like that, they're staring at a fourth down. Well done.
Here's Cameron Johnston now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. As they take over
at their own 34-yard line.
The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. They had a great drive going last time. They were moving the ball, and then all of a sudden it just stalled out. So we'll see what they can do here, Charles.
And it's always easy to second guess when you don't get it on a fourth down try. But they had to like the feeling that they had going on offense. They want to continue to see if they can capture that again on this drive and maybe get in the same position.
Yeah, and that's, I mean, like I said, they were moving the football. It's not like they went four and out, so I don't think it's a deal where the offense doesn't have confidence.
No, I agree with you totally on that one. If anything, they may have gained more confidence. Okay, they stopped us once. That's all right. Let's keep moving it. Make them do it again.
A quick throw complete into the flat-out left. And a six-yard gain gets him right around the 43.
It's a pickup of six.
Brings second up. Quarter, 2 minutes to go. Tie ball game. We remind you that coming up in 2 minutes' time, we'll hand you off to Orlando, where Jonathan Coachman will have highlights and analysis of this first half of action. They'll roll him out right. On the run, he'll let this go deep right side. And he's got him. It's caught. Dez Bryant, 43 yards, and the Saints have taken the lead. And he's got it. It's now a 14-7 ball game.
The score is Saints 14, visitors 7.
And here's Shane Graham now to kick it away following the touchdown. Fields it in the middle of the end zone. And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one.
First down and 10.
The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. That 7-0 lead of theirs short-lived, as they've now given up two straight touchdowns to fall behind by 7.
Yeah, but no cause for discouragement here. Yeah, they've fallen behind, but haven't they proven that they can go down and score? So what was the formula that got them down there the first time? Get back to something close to that, and maybe they can get this game tied up.
Vic operating on first down. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. 17 yards on the pickup there, and the drive will continue.
It is fun to watch the big man work the middle of the field. How about that post route there? Did an excellent job of getting his head around to look the football in and gain significant yardage.
On first down, done. And he's going to take this across the 50 and into Saints territory. The Saints going to call the first of their timeouts as the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half. More muscle up front for this second and two. They've got three tight ends out there. Here's Michael Vick. And a double coverage, and it's intercepted. Derwin James with a pick, and he's able to get it back here to the 43-yard line.
Now, Brandon, this is a veteran quarterback back there. He should know better than to make a throw like this. This is definitely not his best ball, and I think he knew this was trouble the second it was leaving his hand.
First down, Morgan with it. Going deep here for Bryant. And the defense loses him. It's complete. Touchdown, New Orleans. Dez Bryant.
Yeah. Shane Graham ready to get us rolling. And here we go. We're underway in Madden Ultimate Team. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line.
At their own 30-yard line.
So first and 10 now from the 30. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. A try in for Ayuk, but it's intercepted. Picked off by the Pro Bowler, Marcus Peters. And he's going to get this one to the 23-yard line. That's kind of a double whammy. I mean, the interception on the opening drive, that's one thing. But to give him this field position, that's another.
Absolutely perfect start for this defense. They take the ball away on the opening possession. They know that their offense will get the ball to start the second half. They line them up in field goal position, and to me, they got a chance for a touchdown right here out of the gate.
And now the 49ers signal for a timeout defensively. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Morgan off the play fake. Nowhere to turn this time, and he goes down. Sacked back at the 29. That was Ronnie Lott on the safety blitz as he gets the sack.
Second down.
Now Morgan off play action. Throw right side taken in by the tight end Bryant. They get 14 back, but it leads now to a third down.
14, but it's now third down.
Morgan on third and two. Open man there is Patterson, complete. And the Cardinals are going to have first and goal coming up as they're able to convert there on third and two. It's a gain of six as they're able to convert, and now it's first and goal. Here's Mostert. That sends him 2 yards in the wrong direction and leads to second down.
Nice play right there to stop him behind the line, but I want to see how this defense continues to play him here in the first half.
Yeah, we know, you know better than I, he has the ability to take over a game. So what do?
Yeah, I think you have to make sure that you bottle him in at varying levels, because if you crowd everyone to the line of scrimmage, if he breaks through, there's nothing but room to run.
Big play coming here. It's third and goal. And they'll try to run the option here. And he'll fight his way down inside the 10 to the 9-yard line. He'll get a couple of yards on the keeper, but it's going to lead to a fourth down. This situation in the fourth quarter, you go for it. But here, take the points.
If you go for it here and don't get it, you and I are missing our plane, and we're going to the post-game press conference to hear him justify it. Because the next thing we'll see is the owner walking in, announcing a firing. There is no way he goes for it here. Get the field goal. It's the first half of the game. You've got time to make it up.
It's a turnover on downs.
The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. And they've got to be thrilled to have this game still at nothing-nothing after the interception thrown on the very first play of the game.
They certainly do. And what I enjoyed was watching him on the sidelines, because as the defense came off, he was there to congratulate them and really say thanks, because he threw the interception, it didn't turn into any points. But that was an interesting look there, because as soon as he got outside the pocket, I thought he was going to take off and run for yardage. But what often happens now with these quarterbacks who can move, defenses want to try and keep bodies in front of them. And I think that discouraged him from taking off and made him try a pass downfield that fell incomplete.
And he is out up around the 15-yard line. 9 yards, and that leaves him just short. So it'll be third and less than a yard. Third and inches, and they've got some extra beef up front. Three tight ends. Now the first carry for Bush. And he works it across the 25 before being tackled.
49.
The Niners have the first down on a gain of 11. Now back to throw. Over the middle, complete. That's Bush. Call it a pickup of 7, and it's a second down.
A gain of 7 brings up 2nd and 3 at the 33-yard line.
Flushed out right. He's going to take off with it. And he'll be tackled right on the chalk of the 45. A nifty bit of scrambling there. 12 yards, first down.
45-yard line.
We're scoreless after 1.
Quarter with no score.
So after 2 first downs, they get another here. 1st and 10 at the 45. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. Going right side here, and that's complete. And he gets us to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out. 11 more on that one, and another first down.
4-yard line.
On the counter, it's Bush. He's got a first down and more inside the 30.
You know they pay.
And across the chalk, into the end zone, it's a 49er touchdown. Reggie Bush, 44 yards, as his guys are on the board first here tonight. And on that long run, maybe the defense caught napping a little bit.
The concentration level may not have been there. I agree with you on that one, because those types of plays, when they result like that, they're almost like big bolts of lightning, aren't they? Whoosh, and off he goes.
Extra point right down the middle, and it's now a 7-0 game. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. Fields this way up at the 17. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28.
At their own 28-yard line.
Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. They'll be looking to match that touchdown from a moment ago. 7-0 is the score as they begin with a first down. Now an option play, and he'll keep it. Space to maneuver at the 40 as they finally wrangle him in at the 48. First play of the drive, a success, 19 yards.
Well, I tell you, there is no antidote for speed, even at the quarterback position, as he keeps it himself and turns it into good yardage.
And it still takes time for a defender to react, even as quarterbacks carry the ball more and more in today's NFL. They're still a little bit in disbelief and realize, oh my goodness, he's running with the ball. He may be 8, 10, 12 yards downfield at that point.
Now he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. It's another first down, as this time they get an even 20. Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. They just do get the playoff as he'll look to throw. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. Another nice gain, 16 yards there, and a first down again.
Well, it certainly doesn't matter if it's been through the air like on this play or on the ground. I don't know what's going on with this defense. In a sense, they've been AWOL on this drive so far. 3 plays, 3 first downs given up. They've got to find answers, and they've got to find them quick.
2 minutes on the clock, 2nd quarter, 7-0 ball game. We remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll pay a visit to Jonathan Coachman. He's in Orlando, and he'll have our EA Sports halftime report. On 1st and 10, it's Morgan, eluding the pressure right. And he just throws this one away. Smart decision here this close to the end zone, and it brings up 2nd down. So now 2nd and 10 after the incompletion on 1st down. To throw again, Morgan. And they're going to get him. He's sacked back around the 28. Pass rusher extraordinaire, D Ford that time, getting the sack.
Enough takes to start to have a good drive. Quite like a big loss on a sack, does it?
Now they're looking at a 3rd and long, and suddenly the momentum shifted to the other side of the football.
And old Mo is a very, very fickle man.
To throw is Morgan. Off the play fake. Being chased out left.
Fourth down now as San Fran's defense was strong in coverage. More problems here on third down. They've converted only once so far in this first half.
And you know as well as I do in this league, if you don't win on third down, it makes it hard to win a ball game because then you're relying on your defense, you're relying on your special teams. You've got to get it done with your offensive unit.
Makes the score. So they do get the 3 points before they hit halftime. Something to build on, maybe.
Yeah, go ahead and raise the banner, right? Wave the flag. That's good. Got points. And now, as you said, they've got something to build on as they get ready for the second half.
Takes this about 5 yards deep. And tackled at the 21-yard line, so a net negative there of 4 yards.
They're on 21-yard line.
The San Francisco offense ready to start their next drive. And now with still more than a minute to go in what's been a tight game, you figure we'll try to see them move the ball downfield.
And remember, they get the kickoff to start the second half, so this is a...
And that's caught inside the 30. And all the way down to the 24-yard line. A big play there just before halftime. 55 yards. On first down, he'll drop the throw. Under pressure, and he'll go down. Sacked back at the 31. Different story this time around. We had that huge gain followed by a sizable loss here. The first catch of the game for George Kittle. And he's going to take it in. Touchdown, San Francisco. George Kittle in the final seconds of the first half. And the 49ers add 6 to their lead.
And what a weapon he is at the tight end spot, because when they throw him the football downfield, they count on him getting additional yardage almost every time. And that's exactly what he did there. Caught that, ran with it, all the way to the end zone.
Point after, right down the middle. And that pushes the lead up to 11. So not much time to work with here. 9 seconds remain in the half as this one is away. Looking up into the lights, and he muffs it. And he can't. And all deep in his own territory, he coughs up the football. And he will bring this one back. It's a fumble return for the 49er touchdown.
The kicker on.
CD for them. This has just been an offensive explosion here in the second quarter.
Yeah, held scoreless in the first quarter. Now they find the end zone again here in the second. Sometimes you just have to have some patience. A lot of people think it's always an adjustment. You have to change what you're doing. Sometimes you just have to do your game plan just a little bit better. And I think that's part of what we're seeing here.
4 seconds, all that remain here this first half as the kick gets away. It's a short kick taken out beyond the 20.
The Cardinals take over first and 10 at their own 30-yard line.
Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. But we do know there's some risk takers out there that may want to take one more shot before the clock runs out.
First half in the books. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Welcome back. Halftime over. We are ready for quarter number 3. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. It'll be the Cardinals who get the ball first. They trail here as we resume action in the third quarter. It's a short kick taken out beyond the 20.
The Cardinals take over first and 10 at their own 29-yard line.
Morgan now. On first and 10. And down he goes. The 49ers get there. A rookie QB struggling, gets thrown down to the ground there. But, yeah, maybe this game, it's not over yet, but maybe this game can be a learning experience for him.
So many different things that he has to pick up on. When to go ahead and flush from the pocket and run. When to get rid of the football, not
take the sack, when to just go ahead and go down early and make sure you don't fumble the football. So many things that he has to learn. This game starts the process.
This is third down.
Here's Morgan, throwing on third and long. And he's got his man in stride, complete. And he is going to have a Cardinals first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Two catches in the first half. Now he's got a third here, and it's good for a first. Now Morgan, throwing on first down. Pressure from his right, and he goes down hard, flat on his back. Pass protection has been a problem all night long as they come up facing second and a bundle. Another try after the first down sack. Morgan, throw right side, going to be caught by Waller. The reception good for seven. It's third down.
It's a gain of seven. And this is third down.
Throwing from the gun is Morgan. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And he is going to have a Cardinals first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. 12 yards there as they keep this drive rolling. It's another first down. From the gun, it's Morgan. Buying time to his left. And a big loss here as he's taken down. Charles Halen just creating a disaster there for the offense as that one goes 16 yards in the wrong direction. After the sack, oh, they're staring at a challenge basically from the other side of town. It's second and a country mile. And they will only muster a yard here to the 38.
Well, they certainly have been able to get him going and establish the run, so I think it's time to abandon that plan and start chucking it all over the park. And you know who's excited about that? The defensive front. They got just pin their ears back and get after them now.
Throwing on third and long. Morgan escaping the pressure right. And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes.
Sack. A loss of 7 yards. And it's fourth down.
Is going to do it for this third quarter of action. You are watching Madden Ultimate Team on EA Sports. And they're indeed going to go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter, let's see how this plays out. Now here's a deep shot that's complete. And now this is going to...